Hi everyone, and welcome to this video. My name is Christina Aroche and I am the Archangel Channel. And in this video today, I am sharing about the number one mistake that people make when it comes to manifesting. Now, I have definitely made this mistake many, many times in the past. So if this is you, you are definitely not the only one. And it is very common, you know, it's a common thing that happens to many people. And it's also something that we can get better at with practice over time, okay? And this mistake is giving up too soon. Giving up on the dream, giving up on the desire, giving up on the intention. And it's not necessarily like just fully giving up and like, okay, I'm never gonna go for it again. Yes, there may be times or moments where it kind of just feels like, okay, it didn't happen here. Maybe at some point I'll try again. Or maybe I actually need to change this intention to be in the distant future because it might not happen right now. And the thing about doing that is that it is a way that we protect ourselves from feeling disappointed. And when we do that, when we put up that barrier of like, actually, maybe it's not gonna happen now, and maybe I just need to try again later, or maybe I just need to put it off in the distance, or maybe I'll just put it off to the side and do it some other time or whatever, right? That desire, that manifestation, that dream that you want to work towards, is that when we do that, we are, you know, shielding ourselves from feeling disappointed or feeling that failure, that sense of failure, because we didn't go all in. And so the thing is, with regards to this energy of giving up, is that when we do that, when we have that feeling of, oh, maybe next time or whatever, we stop holding the energy, right? So if you think of this in the sense of we're holding the energy, we're holding the space for that creation to happen and for us to receive and for us to be in that alignment, when we start to change, okay, maybe not this time or maybe next time or whatever, that energy that we've been holding, it drops. It drops, and then we're no longer holding that space energetically, and then it doesn't happen, right? And so that is a huge, huge thing to be aware of, right? Is when the fears come up, when the doubts come up, when that energy of like failure, fear of failure, disappointment, all of that comes up. And it often can come up when it looks like it's not happening, right? When it looks like what you desire to create, when it looks like, you know, the things around you aren't lining up, or maybe even something happened where it's like, oh my gosh, like that happened and now it's definitely not the thing that I want, can't happen because of this thing or whatever, right? Sometimes we're in situations where it's actually for us to really lean into this sense of certainty and into our own conviction rather than allowing external circumstances to mean anything, right? But it happens, and things can come up, or doubts can come in, or fears can come in, or doesn't look like it's happening, right? We're looking for external validation, and so we drop the energy. We're no longer holding it. We drop it and we're saying, well, maybe next time, or maybe not, you know, maybe it wasn't meant for me right now, or maybe the universe didn't want to give it to me or whatever, right? Like we have these different excuses or whatever that come up for us that say, okay, it's okay. You're not a failure, right? And so instead of giving up, instead of allowing that energy to drop, here's the thing for you to do, okay? And by the way, this whole topic is inspired by Archangel Shamuel. So you can call Archangel Shamuel to support you with this process. But instead of allowing yourself to give up, instead of allowing the energy to drop, what you can do is, first of all, look at this fear of disappointment, or look at this fear of failure, and see how are you maybe trying to protect yourself from that, right? From this feeling of failure. Oh, I failed. I am a failure, or whatever, right? From this feeling of disappointment, and understanding why you're trying to avoid it and why it feels uncomfortable for you, and you know, all of those things. And one of the things that you can look at with this is for you to understand, you know, what does failure mean about you, or what does it mean to you, right? And so when we start to release and disconnect the feeling of if I fail or if I'm disappointed, it means that I'm not good enough, or it means that I'm not worthy, right? Because usually that's the connection that's there. So when we disconnect those things and we know I'm good enough no matter what, I'm worthy no matter what, it doesn't matter what happens, even if this is a perceived failure, I am still good enough, then there's no fear. There's no fear of failing, because to be honest, there's no such thing as real failure, okay? It's just learning experiences. But when we release that fear, then we have that sense of confidence and that motivation, inspiration to just go all in and to keep going and to rise up into this occasion, right? To show up in the way that we're meant to. The other thing is for you to not seek validation outside of yourself, right? So noticing when you're trying to find the proof, like, is this happening? Is this unfolding? Are people showing up in this way? Is this doing this? Is this doing that, right? And so when we are seeking for external validation or external proof that it's working, then that can also start to have us question ourselves, have us doubt ourselves, because sometimes it's not till the very, very end that things all come into place and click together. Sometimes it's not till, you know, we reach that very limit of like trust and faith, and we are being asked to lean into even further trust and faith. That is how we grow. That's how we grow that trust and faith in ourselves and in the universe, when we're being pushed to that limit. However, if we give up that faith and trust and we just say, look, everything around me says it's not possible or it's not happening, we just lost that faith and trust. And so instead of looking for external validation to tell you, yes, it's working, is leaning into yourself and into your own conviction, into your faith, into your trust, and knowing that that's enough. If you know within you that you are meant for this, you know, whatever the thing is that you desire to create or experience in your life, whatever you're manifesting, if you know that you're capable, if you know that it's possible for you, then it doesn't matter what anything else around you is doing or saying or whatever, right? It's about you and knowing that you can do this, and no one else is there to validate that to you, okay? It comes from yourself. So when you focus on that energy, I promise that the way that your manifestations start to unfold, the way that you show up, the inspiration, the guidance, the action steps that come to you is going to change, and you are going to manifest your desires. So I would love to hear from you in the comments below. Let me know how this helps you. Let me know maybe where is there an area of your life where you were kind of giving up, or where you were kind of pushing it away and saying, well, maybe next time, and where you are recommitting to yourself to not give up. So post that in the comments below, where you are committing to yourself that you're not gonna give up, that you are showing up, that you are capable, okay? I would love to hear from you and cheer you on. And the other thing that I wanna share with you is that the powerful, amazing, incredible workshop that I'm about to teach and share with you and support you through in these last few weeks of August, the Manifestation Portal, the doors are still open. You can still come in and join in, okay? And I would absolutely love to have you in this workshop. It is going to be so incredible, so powerful. This workshop is for you if you are in this place ready to up-level your manifestation game, ready to become a powerful creator, ready to stop being held back by your limiting beliefs and fears and the things that just keep holding you back. You know, this is for you if you are ready to make those big dreams, those big desires come true, and just being in that flow, in that space, in that container that is supporting you. And there's something about being held in this container, and trust me, I'm so excited about this because I'm going to be doing this alongside with you, and I'm excited to be in this container too and holding the space for you in here. And so there's something about being in this container. It's a very powerful energy, right? If you think of energy and how the angels are coming in, they're supporting us through this process, and they're holding the energy for us to be elevated, to break the glass ceiling, to break through our limitations so that we can move into the life that we truly desire, the experiences that we desire, the things that we are meant to be experiencing and doing in our life. Okay, so I would love to have you in the manifestation portal. If this speaks to you, go check out all the details in the description below this video or in the pinned comment below this video. Go check out the details at that link, sign up, come join me. I would absolutely love to have you, and it's going to be powerful. So that's it for today. If you know anyone who needs to hear this message today, please feel free to share this video with them. If you enjoyed this video, then please give it a thumbs up. And if you are not subscribed yet to this channel, then definitely subscribe so that you do not miss any other future videos. Otherwise, I will see you all in the next video. Thank you so much for watching. And as always, I'm sending you so much love and angel blessings. Bye.